dương bàn bất đoàn tìa, rất ẩm nạch bất đạch cả, rồi bỏ bọn ở dòng hôn thèn, đây chỉ rất ẩm nạch bất đạch cả, sẽ hơi khô khơ, cực cực sọc chít xàm sọc cho nằm trong trọc chìm, nâng trọc trang tức này rồi bỏ bởi chi chít khả mại. Tôi sẽ lạc bị phiếp xâm bố thức càng mốc thức càng ngọt, rồi bỏ bộ bọn ở dòng các bọt chít mới cả đập. Rốt bàn đòi xá ca côn trô bị bố cháu dùn trì liền tiên công mà nhìn này ấn đô chân. Sạch cả đầy bất đoàn tiêu rồi bỏ dưỡng bàn cà lai chỉ cả tiêm tiê ôi rọt ẩm nạch cháu, nâng bơ mốc mê đất nôm cháu ôi chốt chênh vì ẩm nạch. Bố tài dưỡng trôn trô ca lũng bạc về tình ý, nâng phiếp ạ dốt để thoa lệnh bàn. Tôi bây chỉ dưỡng bàn ạ nụ cổ, mà đoàn hời mà đoàn tiệt, ôi rọt bọp mafia. Bốc cổ lươi đòi chân rồi bọc bọn ở dòng hồn sáng, chăm sở rốc, tăng bì tiện đại kênh nìa chìa môi cả nạp bạc hôn xì kết tích rồi bọc rần rứt, rồi thơ rớt tập ra khá, tốt rần rứt chánh, rồi rùm rốt chìa môi cả nạp bạc bạc chàng xâm răng xí, ốc bây à nạp, rồi hốt mọc đô nây tệ cả, tì pram thương ngay mọc phai bằng bầy cả cả đá, tì phôn đọc bầy, phôn tài. Với đại dương trọng bán cư cả phạc đô rồi bọc, nâng nạ đất nôm bích và cọt nú Cách lăng mình rùi cho, bố ta đồng ná bà chăng là vụt, bọt bàn rồi bọc cả nạp bạc sẵn cổ chết, bà chôm nâng ca bằng cọp dung cơ nông rồi bọc bọn à dọn. Dương bàn sổ sổ khả nì, ngớp lăng thẳng ọ thả nì, nẹ kháng cơ nông hiền lẹ bọn chì vụt, tìm tia rục dứt tịt hồ, ai nẹ kháng cơ gọc bàn không phân bệnh chui chìa thạ vị cá. Tiếng cầm lạng cái, tiếng cầm lạng bà nhá nâng chất giang sở sẵn, bà thân nà ôi xâm rạch cô đau đò trâm trừ rồi bỏ dưỡng. Tại, bàn lọt tập hồ chú chọt, tổ tù cổ thân nạc đò bắt bóng chì vứt ổ rộp sắp nẹ, bắt khuôn chì chả nẹ, rồi bố chiên xài sụp nẹ, nâng trâu cháu chắp khôn khen ổ mà phải bấy nẹ. Đại lạc cầm bông tờ rộng tì rô nạc cầm, cơ miên bà này bị bộ tê rạch hàn, cơ miên cá đò lén. Tôi bây miên cùng nghiệp bí xã cùng ổn tả chết, nâng ca đoàn tiết tố bí ổn ca xung cung xì viên cả đầy. Bọn chào bằng cơn cầm lăng bị khiết căn tại xã hải lăng, miên bằng chô chàng khiết tại cỏ dưỡng, một nông chúa nẹ bằng cọp, xâm lập khám mai dọc cho nẹ đầy. Hàm mần ôi bởi chứa bởi rốt chú bởi chung khí nét lớp bí bởi bộ nẹ lấy, bằng chôn chôn khiết tại cỏ đầy tỏ tờ rộng khan ca bởi chung tam khách rộng bỏ ảnh nốt bởi thiên cả nạ bạc sẵn cổ chiết, cứ lộp cầm sở khá, rộng chàng phân phong xâm lập lộp hòn. Trầm nay bởi thiên thống, nâng chùm tiếu đạm mê bởi tờ cờ sốc đòi miên lê cho bởi chung nơ rửa nèo bởi tiết suy bắt, tờ nâu tại ảnh nốt bởi thiên, nâng lộp mông sẵn ổn đồ. Bởi thiên vật chủ xâm bọc khẩm, nâng chưa bởi thiên xâm hạ cung nẹ bởi chế thập vật thầy. Vẹn mũ cả nạ bạc, nâng mũ xâm hạ cung bạc đầy tổ tế, to tôi nâng bọn cho hà rồi, tèng phê xa lòn xa lò nụ. Xâm răng xì, không bổng bông xâm lên, gom trò chân. Ta chân bên cầm ra tế, khnông rừng khám ái, kỳ ra chạy bì rẽ xa krom hôn khuôn. Ôi bọn to chui bổng phlanh thôn thiên thua mà chế rõ bọc khám ái. Nâng kênh bảo vãnh cầm mà có khám ái, mình cố rút cho bác ca nghe sạc ở nút. Chân chỉ nhạc công trô rồi thập bị bảo chó, mình bình lạc khả nạc môn kỳ, bằng tốt vì dôn trời quái bú ở dòng một. Hới chân cầm phương ta tốt tốt phó bảo giáo chân nạ, bị lấy xong bảo tiên, đòi bú bảo đại ca hôn sàn. Đôi chân này, cái miên mù là hẹn ở ấy đã thua ở chân bảo bằng cháu, cầm cháy rô bôn liên đà lá, mình toàn sống. Tự chấp rằng xí dốc sở mô nổ lời. Dương khuyên sạp hỡi, thà chân cơ miên ca của rốt chân chạc khám ai mà đoàn là sọc. Tăng bị tế lực bàn ốc và thăm khám ai cỏ hóm, ôi đần đam ông này trong chân năm mươi phần bồn rơi chất sắp rạm, đàm bây chia xâm nón chế sơ. Ông có bóng bón xa tất cả chân, nâng thêm chẳng kích, chỉ nếch bị chồng nón khám ai chân, khăn ông ca xâm lập rộng kí lơ rộng bọc khám ai cỏ hóm phòng. Chỉ tâm ấy mà đoàn tiệt. Bọn nông phân chân rồi bọn mê cả nạ bạc sẵn cổ chết, ôi lúc đáy mọc khăn ông này dô bài bất tích khăn ông rồi bọc khám ái, chỉ chăn tẹn đại thơ ôi nhạc này dô bài khám ái. Chốt cỏ, rộp đồng nò, đốt lại xìa nụ nâng câu nâng chẳng. Tổng vừa ní, có chỉ cá bằng chạy môi ẩn lơ, ẩm phí ế gạp bọt bài chân, làm bấy ẩm nói rồi bọn mê cả nạ bạc bởi trang phong đại. Bởi tích chân nâng bởi tích dốn xuất trên chế bởi tích của mình. ได้บักทวีจมห่อโรคประจำประเทศดำใบแต่ก้าปึงรึงนั่งปึงริสตะกายระบบครูนในแต่บัตสถิเสรีเพียบระบบประจีจุนครูนระโคตรหมกตัวหนังไก่นี้ความโตรแต่ระบบมาเฟียปัดก้าโดยจีระบบหุ่นแสนจะดำรู้จีระบบบังกราบนั่งบังบัตสถิเสรีเพียบด้วยจีระบบครูนได้ให้แทนแต่งรบครุบมัจฉาบตุบตัวประช่างนั่งอัติปลในมนุกกุมวิจิเสรีหมกน้องประเทศบอกครุ่นจินนิการควบโตรโดยรถทวีบาเจ้าระบาคนแสนปีสำนักจันนังยูนมุนคือมุนไอจีอัตที่ข้าสรับไม่คณะปะประช่างกู้แต่ดังท้าประจีประรถขมายอย่างขน้องตรบอย่างคราสรบทุเมียนตรการระบาประดักการกันโดยจิตเมียนตรการระบาก็มันในขน้องประเทศระบาครุ่นหลายนี่จะฉันแต่ระบบประชีพเชิดขมายคณะหน้าได้กิบันสไลประกาศปราบประชีพประทาเกินนึกจมวยประชีพประจินิกเฮ้ยสับตะเก็บใบเจี๋ยแต่สมจันทร์อันตรากุมโดยขมิ้นปีกรัวมัดเตะประชีพประซอกโดยฉะนั้นบันในทางเก็บบดปีประกาศบอกกี้คือบันในทางเก็บเบาปราบประชีพประคือบันในทางเก็บบดฉันจะประชีพประแต่มาดองตาเนื้อรู้จิตเปี่ยสัจจะระบบไม่ดักนอมขณะปะสังกรูเชียนุตาตุ่มเวแบบเนื้อรู้ได้แก่หางท่าทั่วนโยบายสมอตรองจมวิจิตขมายนุรีแอบบ่มนองจังเงี้ยติจ่อจ้าจมวิปุ่เจ้าการอำนาจกระไดกานุก็รึดแต่ข้อปีชันจะระบบปริจิบรถมือจวนเตี้ยให้ในเจ้าเวลกบงโดยจูบุลระบบไม่ขณะปะประชังสังกรูเชียนิเฮยได้จิตกระตาทั่วไอรถอำนาจกระไดการระบบฮุนเซนสมนังจริตเดริชาระบบบกุลผ่องมีนรัตพิบเกินดับปัญจีบรอดขนงสรกโดยมีนยงเยิดนึ่งบังกราบบังสำลับหนึ่งเวบำบะสมารดัยปัตตกออหังสารอดกรีย์ยกชนะใดนุกตาในอริยบายขมายตัวกำห้องระบบครูนหรือตีเรื่องได้กันร้องพอดแต่เฮยกูแต่แนนิยบายขมายกึดหลังวิ่งปุ๊ดเอเรียบอดจังเจ้าจังดำไปร่วมริโรคมัจฉบายทำไมรมดอกประจีตเจี๊ยจังปีอำนาจอัปไรระบบบ้านอยองอ่อยต้นเปลวเลียจะปีแสกำจัดยวนเฉลียนเปลี่ยนตามระยะพลอยฉบับคือตามระยะกระปรมเปลี่ยนปริไงที่มาภัยใบตลาดชนะมวยป้อนประมวลร้อยเข้าสมวยคือตามระยะการเทวกาปโลพนัดกำเนิดนโยบายคือเทวกาปฏิวัติโดยแต่ปฏิวัติการชุบบันเลือกล้างเฉยเรื่อยมันตรึกการรวมจำอ่อยเมียนกาปูโกโจบอหรือกาทีมที่อ่อยเมียนกาบอชนอตซาจิตไม่นุไลปลุกปุจอรวมจำแต่ออกกะนำไปสำรอบคลุ้นเตือนหนึ่งตำรึกการระบบสหกุมอันตรายจิตขนงโกดายบอกสหกุมนิบันต่อถึงจิตเมียนแต่สามกี้เราอย่างขมายกรุบเงินเนียกาเตได้อาจกัดบัญญัติวิธีบอกประระบอยุนนึ่งระบอกปุ่นอายองบานโดยกรมประชาจิตอันตรากาลมุยได้สหกุมอันตรายจิตตุสกอธาจิตดำนางอ้อยขมายเนี่ยประจิตทบไตใส่ในยุ่งดำใบทีมที่อ้อยปฏิหัตทะเลไข่ในกัดปรุงเปลี่ยนกรงปรีที่ไอที่มาไปใบตลาดมวยปอนประมุ่นรอยกระสอบมุยยกสันทิสัญญานี่หมกปีนึกหนึ่งเถื่อกะอนุวัตหลังวิ่งดำใบดังยวนเชิงปีกัมพูชีตามเพลฉบับเฮ้ยบะมันสมรัยจุกใช่ไหมตามเพลโยธีลุตราแต่สมรัยลูกเนกกำปองสนับวิจุปาริวัตกาชุกตามประปวนอินเทอร์เน็ต www.kmelotusrevolution.com มันตบตอนนี้ส่งลูกเนกตามด่านสดับเทคพิพิษาประจุมเนื้อองค์การสหประชาชาติระเวียงโปรตีมวยจำนวนหนึ่งองค์การมวยจำนวนได้อัมพีปัญหากัมพูชีในเพื่อทำไมนี่ยิพิษาอังกฤษจูนเจติสนับโดยต่อเติมThank you.
and Vice President. We welcome Mr. Porto's report and his opening remarks. Cambodia is in the midst of yet another ruling party-created crisis. In the July 28 national elections, the Cambodian People's Party, in power since 1979, controlled and used in a partisan manner all official election-related bodies. This included the National Election Committee and the Constitutional Council, both of which failed to address credible allegations of voter fraud and other irregularities. As a result, the Cambodian people have yet again been deprived of a free and fair election. Government attempts to block peaceful demonstrations demanding an independent investigation into election irregularities have ended in unnecessary or excessive use of force against protesters and bystanders. Without an independent investigation, the opposition is refusing to take up seats in the National Assembly. Meanwhile, the government continues to commit serious human rights violations throughout the country. National and local authorities collude with land-grabbing investors, dispossessing the poor and trampling on their rights. On top of this, land rights protesters are threatened with arrest or violence. Intimidation and criminal prosecutions against defenders and political activists have also become commonplace. The Khmer language media is almost completely controlled by the ruling party. The government has made no progress in addressing impunity that has characterized the administration of Prime Minister Hun Sen over his 28 years in power. Today, the Supreme Court has reheard the case against Bo Sam Nang and Sok Chung Mon, two men who were wrongly scrutiny of Cambodia's precarious and worrying human rights situation, and renew the special rapporteur's mandate for 2 years. Thank you, Madam Vice President.
Thank you. I give the floor next to the International Federation for Human Rights League.
Madam Vice President, Mr. Sir, FIDH and its member organizations, Ad Hoc and Mikado, are deeply concerned about the ongoing, serious and systematic violations of land and housing rights, the intimidation and harassment of Cambodian human rights defenders, and the stifling of independent voices. Land grabbing and illegal forced evictions continue unabated. Evictions are carried out without due process, and those who protest are targeted by the authorities. Land rights activist John Bokha, who was pivotal in the protests of the Bangkok Lake community in Phnom Penh, was convicted on trumped-up charges. September 4th marked the first anniversary of her detention. Human rights defenders, NGO workers, activists, and journalists continue to be subjected to threats, intimidation, and harassment. Peaceful protesters face intimidation and violence. The lack of an independent judiciary makes it possible for the authorities to target independent voices and critics, and impunity is widespread. There are still no suspects for the murders of environmental activist Chu Tuti and of journalist Hang Sarai Udom. Mr. Special Rapporteur, your successive reports highlighted the systematic nature of human rights violations in Cambodia, and your last report stressed the very poor performance of the Cambodian government in promoting and protecting human rights. With regard to electoral reform, none of your recommendations has been implemented, leading to contested election results. The authorities have used excessive lethal force to suppress the last series of protests by opposition supporters, and no later than 3 days ago, law enforcement officials looked on as thugs attacked a group of protesters, reporters, and photographers. Given the situation on the ground and disturbing developments, such as blatant lack of cooperation by the government, who even launched a smear campaign against you, Mr. Special Rapporteur, the Human Rights Council should adopt a strong resolution reflecting the issues, concerns, and lack of progress you identified. We call on the Council to renew your mandate for a period of at least 2 years. I thank you.
I thank you. I give the floor next to International Catholic Bureau.
Madam Vice President, Mr. Special Rapporteur, in Cambodia, serious human rights abuses continue to be perpetrated, including forced evictions and attacks against civilians and activists. Last year, Human Rights Now conducted a fact-finding mission to investigate the land grabbings in Kachay, Bangkok Lake, and Guareke La in Phnom Penh. We found forced evictions in those three cases. There were no legal grounds, and these constituted violations of land rights. Although the government declared a moratorium of economic land concessions, these land concessions continue to be authorized in 2013, and most farmers still do not have land titles. Throughout 2012, the arbitrary arrest, detention, and prosecution against human rights defenders acting on land rights issues are perpetrated by the government, including the detention and prosecution of the radio owner, Mam Sonando, imprisonment of two female housing activists, Chin Sakmoni and Yom Bopa. Ms. Bopa has been in jail for over 1 year now. We also witnessed the police and military use violence against civilians, resulting in the killing of a 14-year-old girl in Brescia last year and of a young man in the course of the post-election protest this month. These violations have been normalized in Cambodia. We express grave concern over the human rights situation and request the Council to extend the mandate of the Special Rapporteur. We urge the Council to closely monitor the situation and strongly urge the Cambodian government to end violence against civilians, to end forced evictions and attacks against human rights activists. Thank you.
That was the speaker from Human Rights Now. We give the floor next to the distinguished representative from Amnesty International.
Madam Vice President, Amnesty International is concerned with the deteriorating situation of human rights defenders in Cambodia and by the role of the justice system in restricting their work. As the Special Rapporteur highlights, quote, judges continue to use the provisions of the Criminal Code against human rights defenders, unquote. Housing rights activist Yoram Bopa has been in prison since September 2012, convicted on spurious grounds after an unfair trial. The courts continue to allow impunity for perpetrators of human rights violations, including against human rights defenders Born Saman and Suk Samun, who remain imprisoned as scapegoats to the killing of union leader Cheya Vichea in 2004, while the real killers have never been brought to justice. As the Special Rapporteur notes, there's been little progress in managing the land crisis, with economic land concessions and urban development leading to forced evictions and land disputes. Following Cambodia's recent national election, Cambodia's political future is unclear. We welcome the public commitment to implement human rights reforms made by both of the main political parties. Increasingly, Cambodians call vocally for changes, including a justice system that protects their rights. We recommend that the Special Rapporteur prioritize judicial reform, following the framework set out in his report to the 15th session of the Human Rights Council in 2010. And beginning with a call for the release of all those who have been convicted and imprisoned unfairly. The Special Rapporteur should also pursue with the government necessary reforms related to the land crisis, including ensuring the provision of legal remedies for those displaced. Amnesty International recommends that the Memorandum of Understanding between the Government of Cambodia and the Office of the United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights in Cambodia be extended for at least 2 years to allow the office to continue its invaluable work in the promotion and protection of human rights and support for the Special Rapporteur's work. Thank you, Madam Vice President.
Thank you. I give the floor next to the Social Service Agency of the Protestant Church in Germany.
Madam Vice President, Special Rapporteur, ICADO welcomes your report and adds its voice to those who have urged the renewal of your mandate. There is a great deterioration in the human rights situation and we are increasingly alarmed by the treatment of human rights defenders. Those who seek to assert their rights in relation to land or labor issues and those who support them, such as NGO staff and journalists, are at particular risk, facing violence, spurious legal action, intimidation and even murder. It is commonplace for the authorities to deploy a range of methods, including gunfire, beating and electric buttons to disperse peaceful demonstrations. Recently, undercover armed force shot dead a man and seriously injured at least 12 others as Crown attempted to return home following an opposition party-led post-election protest. This year, there have been at least 6 incidents of violence used against striking workers by police, private security firms, and employers, resulting in 41 injuries. This constant assault on protest renders the rights of the Cambodian people to freedom of expression and assembly increasingly vulnerable. We urge the Human Rights Council to extend its monitoring of Cambodia by requesting the Special Rapporteurs on the right to freedom of opinion and expression and peacefully assembly and association to conduct studies on their respective issues in Cambodia. Those who perpetrate violent actions against human rights defenders are never punished. In June, a district governor was finally convicted of an intentional violence, having shot and wounded 3 gunmen factory workers during a protest. he has not served a single day of his sentence, and punity needs to be urgently addressed. Mr. Special Rapporteur, we support your recommendations that human rights defenders should be allowed to carry out their work without intimidation and harassment, and your repeated recommendation to strengthen the independence and capacity of the judiciary. Further, we call on the Human Rights Council to urge the Cambodian government to conduct serious investigation into threat and attack against human rights defenders and to prosecute those responsible for human rights violations. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Thank you. I give the floor next to the World Association for the School as an Institute.
Merci, Madame la Vice-Présidente.
Thank you, Madam Vice President. Professor Subedi was able to write two important points into his report on the electoral and judicial reform. The Khmer people are currently living in a state of poverty, corruption, land grabbing by force, perpetual violence, and the breach of human rights, the Constitution, and the Paris Peace Accord on Cambodia in 1991. The majority of the Cambodian people have expressed a desire for change. They clearly expressed their desire to get rid of the yoke of the same authoritarian government for the past three decades. On this occasion, an already flawed electoral system was compounded by a rigged election and manipulation of results. These flaws have angered the Khmer people, and this has resulted in huge demonstrations worldwide to demand justice. As the world has seen, the government's response was repressive measures, such as the use of armed security forces with the support of armored vehicles and guns to frighten the population. Despite the 300,000 petitions to implore the king to postpone the inauguration of the fifth legislature of the National Assembly, they were not allowed to present them until yesterday, September 23. The fact that the opening of the new National Assembly contravenes Article 76 of the Constitution of Cambodia and exacerbates the anger of the Khmer people is being rejected by its citizens. Madam Vice President, we urge the international community to take the revolt of the Khmer people seriously. The Khmer people receive assurances from the international community through the Paris Peace Agreement on Cambodia to enjoy a multi-party democracy. In such a situation, Article 5.1 of the Paris Peace Accord on Cambodia states that a violation or threatened violation of any commitments in the agreement, the signatory countries to this instrument undertake to consult immediately with a view to adopting all appropriate steps. Article 5.4 calls upon the competent organs of the United Nations to take appropriate measures to put an end to these violations, to avoid killing of Cambodian civilians who demonstrate in a peaceful manner to demand justice from the recent elections. Thank you for your kind attention.
Thank you.
ហ៊ុនសែនកំពុងតែក្លាយជាឆ្កែឆ្កួតដេញខំប្រជាជាតិខ្មែរដែលបះប្រឆាំងអំណាចដែលវាបានប្លន់ពីរាជសហរដ្ឋអាមេរិកនិងអឺរ៉ុបតម្រូវឲ្យមានការអង្កេតលើភាពមិនប្រក្រតីក្នុងការបោះឆ្នោតកាលពីថ្ងៃទី28កក្កដា2013ពោលគឺគេគ្រប់គ្រងប្រជាជាតិខ្មែរបំណងធំនៃប្រជាជាតិខ្មែរគឺដេញហ៊ុនសែនជួនផ្ដាច់ការឲ្យចេញពីអំណាចនិងដេញយួនឲ្យចេញពីប្រទេសកម្ពុជាដើម្បីអនុវត្តលទ្ធិប្រជាធិបតេយ្យឲ្យបានត្រឹមត្រូវតើបកសង្គ្រោះជាតិហ៊ានជន់ឈ្លីឆន្ទៈប្រជាជាតិខ្មែរដើម្បីចរចាចូលសភាជាមួយបកប្រជាជនឬទេព្រោះសំរងស៊ីបានបង្ហាញពីល្បិចចាញ់ដោយបានប្រកាសគាំទ្រនយោបាយចិនហើយសូមឲ្យចិនធ្វើជាអាជ្ញាកណ្ដាលដោះស្រាយភាពជាប់គាំងរវាងបកប្រជាជននិងបកសង្គ្រោះជាតិជាការមើលងាយនឹងជន់ឈ្លីឆន្ទៈរបស់ប្រជាជាតិខ្មែរនិងចាញ់ល្បិចកលកុម្មុយនីស្តចិនយួនបកប្រជាជនបើបកប្រឆាំងចរចាជាមួយបកប្រជាជនដើម្បីចូលសភាបកនេះនឹងស្លាប់តៃហោងផ្នែកនយោបាយព្រោះគេលែងជាក្តីសង្ឃឹមសម្រាប់ប្រជាជាតិខ្មែរទៀតហើយប្រជាជាតិខ្មែរនឹងលែងជឿទុកចិត្តលើបកនយោបាយនានា ក្រុមប្រឹក្សាជាតិអន្តរការបានកើតជាពន្លករួចមកហើយនៅថ្ងៃទី1ខែមករា2014នៅទីក្រុងប៉ារីសក្រោមការជ្រោមជ្រែងនៃបដិវត្តកាឈូកនិងសមាគមនានាមានសមាគមទេពនិមិត្តនិងអ្នកស្នាហាជាតិនានាទាំងក្នុងស្រុកទាំងក្រៅស្រុកក្រុមប្រឹក្សាជាតិអន្តរការមានភាពចាំបាច់ណាស់ដើម្បីជាតិរស់ដើម្បីដឹកនាំការរំដោះជាតិខ្មែរពីយួនរំលំរបបផ្ដាច់ការហ៊ុនសែននិងអនុវត្តលទ្ធិប្រជាធិបតេយ្យនៅកម្ពុជាខ្មែរត្រូវតែរួបរួមគ្នាងើបបះបោទាំងអស់គ្នាឲ្យបានខ្លាំងក្លាដោយខ្លួនឯងមុនសិនស្របតាមកិច្ចព្រមព្រៀងប៉ារីសថ្ងៃទី28 ដុល្លារ 1991តាមគ្រប់មធ្យោបាយមានអសហការឈប់គោរពរដ្ឋអំណាចចោលជាដើមប្រហ៊ុនសែនចោលក្បត់ជាតិអាយ៉ងយួនកំពុងក្លាយជាឆ្កែឆ្កួតប្លន់ឆន្ទៈប្រជាជាតិខ្មែរហ៊ានបង្កើតសភាចោលរដ្ឋាភិបាលចោលឲ្យប្រកាសខ្លួនវាជានាយករដ្ឋមន្ត្រីចោលខ្មែរមិនត្រូវទុកឲ្យឆ្កែឆ្កួតចោលក្បត់ជាតិនេះបន្តដឹកនាំប្រទេសដើម្បីឲ្យយួនធ្វើជាអាណានិគមលើស្រុកខ្មែរបន្តបានជាង35ឆ្នាំមកហើយបែបនេះទៀតទេ